So what's up, guys? Today I'm in a car, I'm stuck in traffic, and I had this amazing idea to make a video. So don't mind me if I'm not looking at the camera because I have to, you know, pay attention so I don't die. Today I'm going to be talking about how Teslas can't have the 360 camera. A lot of people think that because the Tesla has 8 cameras and whatnot, it has eyes 360 degrees around the car, that you can put like a 360 camera in your car, what BMWs, Nissans, Infinities, all those other cars, car manufacturers actually add. There's actually a big problem to why they cannot do that. I'm going to be explaining that in this video, so stay tuned, keep watching, and hopefully stay interested. Let's get started. So the first reason will be that the cameras aren't pointed in the right direction. Now, of course, the cameras are looking everywhere. They're looking 360 degrees around the car, but they're not pointed in the direction you want, especially not in the directions you want it for an actual 360 camera on your center dash. For a 360 view, you would need about 4 cameras. One's usually at the front, at the logo, near the logo, somewhere there. One's at the back, usually near the logo, or like the button for the tailgate or lift gate, whatever, the trunk, whatever button there is back there. And then you would have 2 more, one on each side mirror. That would give you a full 360 view. So how the cars accomplish this 360 view is the back camera points back in a wide angle, side cameras point kind of side, but just a bit towards the back in a wide angle. The front camera points straight in like a wide angle, so you actually see the ground and everything. But the Tesla cameras, they can't really see the ground, I'll say that. So the cameras aren't pointed in the right direction. They're actually meant for the autopilot system. They're not meant to give you any convenience advantage of a 360 camera. And there's a good reason for that, because they can add more cameras to make it 360, but you don't need them. Why don't you need them? Well, the reason is that you actually won't be driving the car all that much. So most of the time, especially if you bought the full self-driving option, you won't even drive the car, so you won't even need to know. The Tesla today can get out of a parking spot, even park in a parking spot itself. You can't just leave the car to let it do that by itself. You have to actually physically go near the parking spot and then select, oh yeah, auto park and whatnot. You can summon the car towards you at like at the front of a gate of a store or something. So in general, you don't really need it today anyways. It's for the people who didn't buy it, so it doesn't really matter much anyways. Now, when more people start using full self-driving, when Tesla actually releases more of their features of full self-driving, you won't actually need the cameras, the 360 cameras. Think about it this way. What are 360 cameras actually used for in cars? They're used so that if you can park easily, you can see where your tires are, you can see all your surrounding, know everything about it, and you don't actually hit anything. But if the cameras can already do it along with their sensors, then there's really no point. It's just a waste of hardware, basically, because you won't be using it in the near future. And the reason they designed their cars in such a way is that, oh my gosh, this light only lasts like 10 seconds. Not even 10, it's like 5 seconds. The reason they designed their cars that way is so that you actually buy the full self-driving option, because they know that otherwise you don't need to keep it that way. It's a good thing, but generally, I would assume Tesla has thought of it through so that when their plan actually comes into fruition, they would know that the people wouldn't actually want or need, or have a need at least, for the 360 camera, because you actually don't need it. So what I'm gonna do is actually show you on my Infiniti. So in my Infiniti SUV, here you can see that I have 360 camera on the center dash. Once I put into reverse, they pop up. Amazing, amazing feature, especially for that SUV. Oh my gosh, is it such a breeze to park that car. Because of that, I would need at least a backup camera in that car, but otherwise I think I should be fine. But generally the 360 cameras help a lot, especially in that SUV where the visibility is not even that good because everything is so high up. How do they work? Well, there's one camera right under the Infiniti logo at the front, in the front grille. There's a second camera at the back, of course, the back camera. The last two cameras are actually located under each of the side mirrors. That's how you get the 360 view. Now, BMW does something different, and I'll explain it using the Infiniti, of course. BMW, what they do is they try to make like a 3D replica of the 360 camera. So they actually make it like as if you can like roam around and actually see across the car. So how do they do that? They basically take the same cameras like I told you, except they have one sidewards facing camera on each of the bumpers. So on the front bumper, you have two sideways facing cameras outwards. And on the back bumper, you have two sideways facing cameras outwards. And obviously you would have them under your side mirrors and everything, just so that you can get the 360 view that you wanted. That's what happens in a BMW. That's how they create the 3D visualization. In a Tesla, none of the cameras are positioned in a way that you can actually make that happen. Now you can make some sort of 3D diagram just to, if you wanted, with like their sonar sensor radars and all that, but generally speaking, it's much more complicated, and considering you wouldn't even want to use it after like 2-3 years whenever they release your full self-driving and when you actually get it, there's really no point in actually having the 360 camera. Everyone says they want a 360 camera, and let me tell you, this car doesn't have a 360 camera. I don't mind it because it's a car, so it's not as bad, but in an SUV, I definitely want one. I haven't driven the Model X. I've been in a Model X while I was driving, and I think visibility is not as bad as you think, because the back camera is really wide, and what the sensors do is they do a clever thing. They actually tell you the exact distance they are away from the object when you're going forward or backwards. Say you're parking into a garage forwards. If you have boxes or just stuff laying around, right? It would actually tell you the exact distance you are away. It's not like a distorted camera angle where you just slowly going forward, going forward, going forward, and then next thing you know, you just basically hit it. I feel like that's a better step in the right direction than adding 360 cameras, especially if you're not going to use it. So it all comes down to the fact that most of the people won't actually use it in the near future. They will now if Tesla actually implements it, but in the near future, once they get their full self-driving out, I doubt anyone will actually be using the cameras at all for parking, especially because, go ahead buddy, it's a Range Rover too, I can allow you. That is the biggest reason why Tesla doesn't actually implement it. It's not like it's just a software update. Now if they wanted to, if the cameras are positioned in that way, because you have one camera at each B pillar, they can possibly make a 360 view if it's wide enough, but you don't have a front camera because your front camera is not located in the front grille area or just right in front of the bonnet, the hood. It is actually located, oh my gosh, man, so much traffic. Are you crazy? All I want to do is go through, oh my gosh, there's a truck stopped at the side of the road. Oh my gosh. So yeah, they can possibly do it. And maybe they might if it is positioned that way, but considering we haven't seen any footage from the B-pillar cameras, it's hard to say anything, really. So, yeah. So that's why it's kind of hard to develop, kind of, you know, more difficult to make a 360 camera. Honestly, I don't actually mind. I'd rather have their team focus on full self-driving and get that ready rather than focusing on a 360 camera. That's just my one word piece of, not one word, it's like a long video too, anyways. So yeah, I would like to thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this one. I basically talked while sitting in traffic. I swear I only moved like 200 meters in the time I talked this whole video. It's been like 12 minutes. Holy shit, boxing in traffic is insane. Damn. Oh, Model 3 is coming back. Amazing. By the way, the white Model 3 looks amazing. I don't like the other colors, I only like the white. Just looks so clean and minimalistic, especially the white interior. Oh my gosh, yes, I need it. Anyways, thank you for watching. Hope to see you later. Hope you watch my other videos. By the way, subscribe. Please subscribe. See, I'm looking at the camera. I'm risking my life to tell you, subscribe. Okay, see ya. Peace.